Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us here at City Hall this morning. I'm Jennifer McKelvie, Councillor for Scarborough Rouge Park and Chair of the Infrastructure and Environment Committee. I'm pleased to welcome Mayor John Tory and Deputy Mayor Michael Thompson today for an announcement on behalf of the City and its Parks, Forestry and Recreation Division. I'd like to invite Mayor Tory to come forward to speak.
Well, Councillor McKelvie and Deputy Mayor Thompson, thank you. And I want to thank them both for being here. Councillor McKelvie and Deputy Mayor Thompson both have responsibility in the areas that are covered by the literally thousands of jobs that we are making available today for application. And I'll talk about those jobs because they come open each year and represent a very important source of employment for young people principally, but not limited to young people. And I think in this year of recovery, they represent an important step forward in terms of the availability, once again, of a full roster of programs, but also these employment opportunities that go with them. And I thank both Deputy Mayor Thompson and Councillor McKelvie for their work chairing the committees and looking after the areas of the city's government that put these programs forward and create these opportunities for employment. This is the day on which we launch the annual hiring campaign for summer parks and recreation jobs. And I think it represents another sign that we are moving forward, that we are opening up, and that we're able to welcome more people back to the city, welcome more people back to work, and welcome more people to participate in city programs and activities. Throughout the pandemic, we've seen how important parks, recreation, recreational facilities and programs and other public spaces and activities are for the mental health and the physical health, for that matter, of people resident in the City of Toronto. While in lockdown, residents did use public spaces as an outlet to get outside and to have their daily walks and activities, and this was very important to their physical and mental health during a period of considerable confinement. And throughout the pandemic, we made an extra effort as a city government to make sure that these spaces were open, that they were safe, and that they were accessible to all of our residents. We adapted to create new programs like Camp TO, Parks Play TO, and Summer in the Six, which were all about providing recreational activities, but providing them in a way that was safe, consistent with public health guidelines in place at the time, understanding at those points in time through the 2 years of the pandemic so far, the paramount importance of maintaining public health. With the end of winter now coming closer, we're ready to welcome spring and summer with a variety of programs that come each year in spring and summer, new programs for 2022. Like every year, when the days get longer and the weather gets warmer, a hiring spree begins on the part of the city to ensure that all of these programs are properly staffed and that the thousands of jobs related to our recreational programs and gardening are filled. Today I'm here with Deputy Mayor Thompson and Councillor McKelvie to remind residents of the parks and recreation job opportunities available for the spring and summer that help keep these services running safely and efficiently and that provide the employment opportunities that are so important for so many in our city. Although hiring for parks and recreation is a year-round initiative, there's a strong focus on summer employment. The city itself is Toronto's largest provider of recreation services for all ages, interests, and skill levels, and with that goes a lot of good jobs. Annually, we as a city employ approximately 9,000 recreation workers year-round, including 5,000 people who are employed exclusively during the summer season. And it's the case, and I know Deputy Mayor Thompson and Councillor McKelvie will back that up from their own encounters with the staff. Many, many of the staff that are permanent today in their adult years, if I can call it that, or in their working careers, had their start in one of these summer jobs, and they are very devoted to the well-being of these programs and of the residents and parks and recreational facilities in the city. So once again this year, this means that many different kinds of jobs are open for application, and that includes lifeguards, swimming instructors, camp counselors, fitness instructors, performing arts instructors, and hip-hop and line dance teachers, and many more in different categories. These job applications are open now and will be open into March and early April. Additionally, over 900 seasonal gardening and parks handiworkers are employed each year. And we're currently accepting applications for seasonal gardeners and parks handy worker positions. These people are responsible for horticultural and turf maintenance, for litter picking, and for minor repairs in parks across the city. The posting for seasonal gardeners, these postings, will be open until March 22nd or until the positions are filled. So I guess the bottom line message is that you can go now to have a look at these. They do fill up fairly quickly because these are, you know, good jobs. They're, in many cases, outdoor jobs and the kinds of jobs that people find, I think, both very fulfilling and also very conducive to enjoying the summer. The jobs are equally important for people who are accessing these services over the course of the spring and summer. Health measures for recreational programs align with provincial guidelines and rules that are in place from time to time and with Toronto Public Health guidance. And these are the people that not only offer these programs, offer their expertise to transfer a skill or to just have some fun, but at the same time, they're also the ones watching over the safety of these programs in a post-pandemic world. We will be having two upcoming specific information sessions with respect to these spring and summer jobs taking place tomorrow, Saturday, February 26th, with further related sessions scheduled throughout March and April. At these sessions, it's really meant as much as anything else to learn about the jobs, but also for people who may not have applied for a job like this before due to their age. And it gives them a bit of a hand in what to expect in the hiring process, how to make up a proper resume and interview skills that are, of course, going to be helpful in going through application for these positions. The sessions are geared towards young people who are entering the job market sometimes for the first time, and it's meant to make things smoother for people who wish to apply for these positions. I hope all of this, you know, all the different steps that we're taking are signals of better days to come, because that is very much how we feel. It is very much how we can be cautiously optimistic, to use the expression that Dr. Davila uses, in light of the different numbers that are in front of us and the science that we rely on so much in helping to make the city's decisions as to things we proceed with and what measures we leave in place and which ones we make modifications to. We are talking today about 6,000, nearly 6,000 good summer jobs, jobs that will move our city in the direction of reopening, jobs that will move our city in the direction of recovery, and jobs that will help people move themselves to a position closer to that of a normal life. The jobs will help to boost our economy because it puts money in the pockets of people who need that money, whether it's to pay their educational expenses or just to live. And it will also put some energy into our city, its vibrancy, providing new opportunities for young people to build up their working skills and their confidence and their resumes all at the same time. These are impactful employment opportunities for people of all ages, but especially for young people and for residents across the different neighborhoods in the city from different age groups. And I want to encourage everyone and anyone who would have the interest and the availability to fill one of these positions to apply, to check them out at toronto.ca, and to consider working with the city to take advantage of these opportunities. And I would now like to ask Deputy Mayor Thompson to say a few words about these programs and opportunities that we're announcing today.
Thank you very much, Ms. Mayor, and good morning. I'm delighted to be here to support the thousands of staff members who create and operate the city's high-quality public recreation programs. These programs promote physical activity, nurture social connections, and of course, develop and train future leaders. Recreation plays a vital role in promoting and reinforcing personal, community, and of course, economic well-being, as the mayor has just indicated. These programs also offer another substantial benefit. Specifically, the excellent job opportunities they create in our communities. Work in recreation often leads to a career in public service, a career path built on compassion, commitment, courage, and leadership. And I embody that. The mayor has spoken about the opportunities that have come through these programs. I, in fact, worked as a parks and recreation rink rat many years ago. That has led me now to public service. And it has actually reinforced the fact that my career is built on compassion, commitment, courage, and leadership. So I embody the very thing that we're speaking about today. So for all those young people that are out there looking for opportunity, as the mayor has indicated, these are excellent opportunities for you to be able to develop your skills and to create a future where you're able to develop leadership skills, and work with the community and so on. I can tell you my experience, which has been phenomenal, and I want to encourage each and every one of you to take a look at these opportunities in terms of applying for these jobs. It's a great start. It's a great opportunity for each and every one of you. You can find details and about these positions that are available and any other information by visiting the city's website at toronto.ca/recreationjobs. And it is now my pleasure to ask Councillor McKelvie to speak about the parks jobs opportunities that are now available. Councillor McKelvie.
Thank you, Councillor Thompson, and thank you, Mayor Tory, for both sharing your strong commitment to a fun and safe summer and also the job opportunities that are opening up today. Toronto's more than 1,500 parks and green spaces are vital for our urban environment. Parks are where families and communities gather outdoors, and they rely on the city for those spaces to be ready for them and keep them safe and clean for everybody. We want young people, newcomers, and seniors to feel encouraged in their job search efforts, and please apply at the city. I want to take this opportunity again to encourage people from all walks of life to consider working with the city and to help create positive changes within their community. A very, very big thank you to our City of Toronto staff and their hard work and dedication in making this happen both this year and every year. Thank you, and media will now be able to ask questions.
Thank you, Councillor McKelvie, Mayor Tory, and Deputy Mayor Michael Thompson. We'll now take questions from the media. As a reminder, it's one question, one follow-up. We do also have staff on the line if you do have any technical questions. First up, we have David Ryder from The Star. Go ahead, David.
Hi, all. I've read in some jurisdictions, both in Ontario and also the United States, that open their seasonal hiring earlier than Toronto does, that they've actually had some challenges filling them, that like we've seen in many parts of the job sector during the pandemic, that in some cases it's a bit of a shortage. Is there any way of saying yet right now whether that's a challenge and if the city might need to do anything to get to fill all these positions?
Well, I don't know whether anybody that's on the line from the staff wants to indicate based on preliminary, because some of these applications have been open for a while now, whereas the bulk of them, I think, are coming due now, so we wouldn't yet have an indication. Does anyone want to address that from the public service?
Aiden, do you want to go ahead?
You unmuted him.
Sorry, one sec. Aiden, can you hear us?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, go ahead.
I agree with the mayor. I think at this time it's premature to comment on that as these applications are just coming in. However, we will be in a better position in a few weeks from now. Thank you.
And David, I'll just add to that. I mean, my determination on behalf, I'm sure, of Deputy Mayor Thompson and Councillor McKelvie and the whole of the city administration will be to make sure if things are a bit slower coming in that we ramp up the publicity. There's a lot of people out there that need these jobs, especially students, and I don't think they would have been in the category of people because they've been at school that would not have been coming back to work in the kind of receding time of the pandemic. So we'll ramp it up if we have to make sure those jobs get filled, because I think those programs are more needed than ever. There's been a lot of trauma that's been caused by the pandemic and all that has been associated with it, all the isolation and so on. And I think these kinds of programs in the summer months, hopefully with the pandemic, getting into the rearview mirror, are more necessary than ever. And we need the staff, obviously, to make sure they're properly run.
Thank you. My follow-up is about vaccination. And so a lot of teenagers have had two doses of vaccine. Some have had three. What is the requirement for anybody who wants to work for one of these jobs as far as how many doses of COVID-19 vaccine they need to have had?
I think I know the answer to that, but I want to make sure by asking a public servant to talk about the definition of full vaccination that still is in place. Is there somebody that can answer that question on the line?
We don't have anyone on the line from Toronto Public Health, so we can get you a specific answer after.
I believe the answer that they will confirm, David, is that our definition of what is required is consistent with the city's policy that is remaining to be in place, the vaccine mandate that says two doses are satisfactory to pass that hurdle, and I don't think that has been altered for other jobs or for these jobs, but we'll get them to confirm that with you.
I'll actually check if Aiden does have an answer to that. Aiden, do you want to go ahead?
Yes, thank you.
Sorry.
The mayor is correct. At this point, at this time, our vaccination policy requires 2 doses.
Okay, that's actually it for today. David was our only question. So thank you, everybody, for joining us. Have a great day.
Thank you, everybody.